Hi students, welcome to the another session of our 8th class physics. That is of the chapter 8, that is combustion fuels and flames. We are discussing about the part 4. Okay, in this part 4 we were talking about what are the types of combustion and some more, what is the highly inflammable substances and what is explosion, how, what are the spontaneous combustion is and what are the rapid combustion, what are the examples and all we are going to discuss in detail. That is the agenda of this session. Before that, already we have discussed that combustion is a process, is a process which is going to, the substance is going to react with oxygen present in the oxygen, so the present in the air, the substance or the process of reaction by the oxygen to get the flame is called as combustion. The process of reacting with the oxygen to produce the flame can be considered as combustion. Okay, heat and flame is considered as combustion. The chemical process which is going to react with, which is going to be performed or executed due to the reaction with the oxygen present in the air to get fire and heat is considered as combustion. Okay, that's already we have discussed. Now, how many types of combustions are there? Okay, that's what we have to discuss in this segment. Before going to discuss that, we have to understand some concepts. Some concepts we are going to understand. Okay, go to page number 111, all of you, as per the textbook which is having in my hand. That is activity 4. After activity 4, this diagram, we have the types of combustion. During the summer time, the dry grass catches fire in the forest. It may spread to the trees and very soon the whole forest will be on fire. And it is very difficult to control the forest fire. Okay, on very hot summer, the dry grass which is present in the forest will catch fire, just like that it will catch fire. And it is very difficult, and that fire which is caught, it is going to spread to the trees, and within less time the total entire forest will be on fire, and such type of forest fire will not be controlled easily. It will be very difficult to control those. Okay, in what is happening in the head of the matchstick? Okay, if the head of the matchstick is struck, matchstick is rubbed on the sides of the matchbox, it starts burning. Why the match stick to catch? Okay, what makes the match, what makes matchstick to catch fire? What is making the matchstick to catch? We are familiar, right? We will catch matchbox to light a candle or to light incense stick or to light anything. We strike the matchstick on the sides of the matchbox to get it fire, to get it fire. What is the process or what is happening in that process, in that activity that we are going to discuss? That is, when we are striking that matchstick on the sides of the matchbox, why that matchstick is able to catch fire is what we are going to observe. Of course, I would have bought that matchstick, but forgot to bring. Okay. A mixture of antimony potassium chlorate and white phosphorus. Okay, white phosphorus with some glue and starch was applied on the head of the matchstick. Okay, and which is suitable for making the matchstick on the wood. Okay, along with this, some glue will be there and starch. Mixture of all these will be kept. Assume this is the wood of the matchstick, and on the head of this matchstick, okay, This head of the matchstick contains, the head of the matchstick contains all this. It contains antimony trisulfide, potassium chlorate and white sulfur, and mixing of glue and starch. Mixing of all these, they are going to be placed on the wood, which is suitable for making the matchstick. Okay, and white phosphorus is, okay, this is how, say antimony trisulfide, potassium chlorate, white phosphorus, and along with some glue, some gum, and with starch, which is going to be have a mix. That mix is being kept on the, this is this small, the head of the matchstick is contains all these chemicals and these substances, which is being kept on the head of the stick. Okay, head of the matchstick made of suitable wood. This is made up of suitable wood. When it is struck against the rough surface, the white phosphorus got ignited due to the heat of friction. Okay, when this matchstick has been striked, okay, the matchstick is being striked on the when it is being striked, is the sides of the matchbox. See, when it is being striked on the match sides of the matchbox, the potash, the white phosphorus which is present in this will get ignited. It will reach to the ignited state due to the friction. When we strike that, it will catch due to the friction between that. It will friction between the matchstick and this side of the. Friction between the matchstick head and the sides of the matchbox creates some heat, ignite heat, and due to the heat, the white phosphorus will be ignited and it is going to catch the fire. Okay. See, when it strike, that is matchstick is strike against the rough surface, the white phosphorus got ignited due to the heat of friction. It starts the combustion of the matchstick. Okay, whenever we have strike due to the friction between the matchstick and this matchbox side of the matchbox, the white phosphorus gets ignited and it is going to be combustion. It is going to execute the combustion process of this matchstick. Like that, we are going to get the fire. This was initial days, the beginning of the manufacturing of the matchstick. It has been, these were the chemicals which were used in the head of the matchstick. Okay. This earlier time, before the first stage of introducing of the matchstick, these are the antimony trisulfide, potassium chlorate and white phosphorus and glue and starch were used at that time. But as there is a drawback here while using this all three chemicals, that is white phosphorus is very much danger for the workers who are manufacturing as well as for the users of this also, or consumers. Okay, who is our workers or who are the users also, who is making the matchstick by using these chemicals, the product white phosphorus is very much dangerous because it is going to catch fire just faster. Okay, working with this potassium phosphorus is danger to make that, and while using the matchstick also, it is going to be considered as not suitable for using the work. See here, however the white phosphorus proved to be dangerous for both for the workers involving in the manufacturing of the matchbox and for the users. This is white phosphorus is dangerous for the the workers who are manufacturing the matchstick and the matchbox, and for the users also, those who are using also. But as this was earlier time, this was not now, in the earlier days, the earlier days of the invention of the matchstick. Now, but these days, the head of the safety matchbox these days the head of the safety matchstick contains only antimony trisulfide and potassium chlorate. Nowadays this white phosphorus is not being used. Of course it will be converted as white phosphorus. How it is getting converted, let's see. Okay, instead of using white phosphorus in the head,
only these two substances, only these two, antimony trisulfide and potassium chlorate, only these two substances will be used in the head of that is white phosphorus has been taken off. Okay, how it is been getting converted, that I'll tell you. Chlorate, by rubbing the surface has powdered glass and little red phosphorus, which is less dangerous. When the mastic is struck against the rubbing surface, some red phosphorus get converted into white phosphorus. Okay, so what happens is, see, rubbing surface has powdered glass. This rubbing surface or surface on that will have some powdered glass, like glass particles like powder, and along with red phosphorus. Okay, this rubbing surface here or on this surface, on this slide, instead of using the red phosphorus, it is used as red phosphorus. Red phosphorus along with powdered glass. In the place of white phosphorus, red phosphorus along with powdered glass will be there on the rubbing surface. This rubbing surface on that the main surface of that the main top surface, rubbing surface of the matchstick. Okay, whenever there is striking, when the matchstick is struck against the rubbing surface. Okay, whenever the matchstick here also. On the matchbox also, it might be with the red phosphorus and powdered glass may contain on this rubbing surface which is side to the matchbox also. Okay, whenever this matchstick is struck on the rubbing surface of the matchbox, rubbing surface. See, this red surface is red phosphorus is less dangerous. Whenever the matchstick is struck against the rubbing surface, some red phosphorus get converted into white phosphorus. Whenever we are striking that, the red phosphorus is going to be a small little amount of red phosphorus due to the friction or due to the rubbing activity. When it is rubbed, due to the rubbing, the red phosphorus will be converted into white phosphorus. Okay, this immediately reacts with potassium. Okay, after conversion of this red phosphorus to white phosphorus, due to striking, it is going to convert it into white phosphorus. It's going to convert into white phosphorus due to striking on the surface, which contains red phosphorus and some powdered glass. When that matchstick has been struck, the red phosphorus being converted into white phosphorus, and this white phosphorus immediately reacts with potassium chlorate. The white phosphorus immediately reacts with potassium chlorate in the matchstick head to produce the white phosphorus. See, red phosphorus and glass powder is present on the sides of the rubbing surface of the matchbox. When red phosphorus is converted into white phosphorus, when the matchstick is being helped, it will be here itself. Matchstick head, due to the rubbing, the red phosphorus converted to white phosphorus, and it is reacting with the red phosphorus. White phosphorus reacts with the. Try to understand. Red phosphorus is present on the rubbing surface. When it is striking, the matchstick is being tried. Due to the rubbing, some amount of red phosphorus is converted into white phosphorus. The white phosphorus is going to react with the potassium chlorate, with the potassium chlorate present in the head of the matchbox, so that it gets chlorate in the matchstick head to produce enough heat to ignite. Okay, it is going to give, when due to the reaction with the white phosphorus to this white phosphorus, converted white phosphorus to this potassium chlorate, it is going to produce some heat, some sufficient amount of heat, which is going to ignite, which is going to burn. Ignite this antimony trisulfide, okay, which is going to ignite produce enough heat to ignite antimony trisulfate and start the combustion. See how much reaction has been taking place in that second, just rubbing, hitting. Okay, whenever we are hitting this or striking, whenever we are striking the mastic is going to be striking, due to striking the red phosphorus, is a little amount of red phosphorus which is present on the sides of the matchbox is converted into white phosphorus. That white phosphorus immediately reacts with the potassium chloride, will create some heat. That due to the heat, that the temperature of the antimony will be ignited, and due to the ignition, the antimony reacts fast. This antimony catches the fire where the mastic is going to catch the fire. This much thing will happen in that fraction of seconds. Okay, when we are hitting that matchstick to the surface of the rubbing surface of the matchstick, matchbox, red phosphorus present in the surface of the matchbox is going to convert as white phosphorus, is going to react with antimony, potassium chloride. Potassium chloride creates some heat. Due to the reaction, some heat is being produced. That heat will ignite this antimony trisulfate, makes the execution of combustion, gets that matchstick catches fire. Okay. Initially, antimony trisulfide, potassium chloride and white phosphorus were used in head of the mastic, where ignoring of that white phosphorus from the head of the mastic, red phosphorus and powdered glass is being placed on the matchbox. Okay, this is how the mastic is getting, it's catching the fire. A small explanation. Now, understood? Three chemicals. Earlier, in the initial days, three chemicals were used on the head of that. After that, taking the white phosphorus as danger, consists of dangerous, and then in place of white phosphorus, red phosphorus and glass powder is being placed on the surface of the matchbox. Due to the striking, while red phosphorus, a little amount of red phosphorus will be turned into white phosphorus. After conversion, that is going to react with the potassium chloride present in the head of the matchbox. That potassium chloride creates some heat. That heat will ignite this antimony trisulfide. Is due to the heat and ignition, the mastic starts burn. Okay, this is a small process which is, see, this much process is going to be executed within fraction of seconds. So this is what happens. Okay, what makes the mastic to catch fire? For that question, this much process we have explained. Now we are going to discuss about what are the types of combustions. Okay, according to that, we have two types of combustions. Okay, we have two types of combustion. This first one is spontaneous. Spontaneous combustion. And the next one is rapid. Spontaneous combustion and rapid combustion. See, the type of combustion in which materials suddenly burns into flame without the application of any external agent is called spontaneous combustion. Okay, some materials are there. Suppose if they are some materials are there where they are burning. If suddenly they get fire. Some materials are burning, while burning, okay, burning into flame, suddenly burns into flame. That burning process into they catch the flame, they convert it into flame suddenly. Such type of spontaneous, suddenly it happens, where the combustion or the execution of fire takes suddenly. Okay, that type of combustions we are calling as spontaneous without any external agent. That will happen. This conversion of burning to the flame will happen without adding any external agent that will take place. That type of things we are calling as spontaneous combustions. See, the combustion in which material suddenly burns into flame. All of suddenly the material starts burning into flame. They catch fire into flame. Such type of combustions we are going to call, and without any external agent. How this burning material is going to be converted as flame without any agent, without any external agent, if they are going to convert it, such type of combustions we are calling as spontaneous combustions. And rapid combustions, to know the rapid combustions, what we have to do, turn on the knob of the gas stove. When we turn on the gas stove in the kitchen and bring a burning mastic or a gas lighter near it. When we bring a gas lighter or burning mastic near it, okay, the gas burner rapidly, the gas burns rapidly and produces heat and light. When we turn on, the gas burns rapidly, faster, just spark of light. A little spark of light is going to make that gas to burn, catch fire and burns and gives heat and light. Such type of combustion are called rapidly, faster. It will happen fast, rapidly it will catch fire. Some substances, if the combustion takes place rapidly, fast it is going to execute it. The combustion is executed faster, rapidly if it is going to execute it. Such type of combustion we are calling as rapid combustion. That is starting of the igniting that stove whenever we are bringing, catches fire faster, as fast as it is. Okay, materials such as spirit petrol and camphor burns even with a small spark from the gas lighter. See, petroleum and spirit and campers, it will burn with a light spark also. A little spark of that light also make it burn. Okay, so this is about, so the combustion takes place rapidly, as fast as it is can be processed, rapid combustion. All of a suddenly, if any burning substance material is going to catch fire without any external agent, it is called as spontaneous combustion. Sorry. Now, one, do you know segment we have, that we have to go with? See, you might have noticed the do you know segment. I am going to read in page number 112. See, you might have noticed the word written as highly inflammable. See, that already we have discussed. See, some, if you go to the petrol bank with your father or your brother or any elder, there will be a board written on that nearby the petrol pump. It is petrol, that is highly inflammable substance. Okay, on the petrol tankers, or sometimes when the tanker goes, when the petrol tankers are going on the roadside, if you see the petrol tankers consisting of the notations on that is highly inflammable. On petrol tankers it will be written. Okay, highly inflammable, that is that they are going to catch fire rapidly. Okay, this is a warning to the public to keep flame away from the inflammable materials. That is because to keep the fire away from the tanker. Okay, for the public, to create the awareness and warning for the public to keep away the fire from the tankers. Okay, now we have that is about highly inflammable substance. Highly inflammable substance. What is the LPG? LPG is the liquid petroleum gas, and petrol, diesel. These all are highly inflammable substances. Okay. Now we are going to see about explosion. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about explosion. See, we generally enjoy the sound and light from the fireworks on festival days. On Diwali, okay, festival days, we'll enjoy that light and sound which is being emitted by that fireworks. Okay, when a cracker is ignited, a sudden reaction takes place with the evolution of heat, light and sound. When a cracker is burned, it is going to give heat, it is going to produce heat, light and sound. Okay, a large amount of gas is also liberated in this reaction. released in that reaction. Such reaction is called explosion. Explosion can also take place when the pressure is applied on the crackers. Not only burning, when the pressure is applied on the crackers, then also the explosion can take place. Okay. Not only while igniting the crackers, if there is a much pressure also on the crackers, if there is much pressure, that time due to that also the crackers can get ignited and they can have the explosion. Explosion can take place if the pressure is applied on the crackers. The pressure is applied on the crackers, explosion can also may be executed. Okay, this is explosion, is burning of the crackers, where it is going to give huge amount of sound and huge amount of light and huge amount of heat. If it is generated, such type of reactions can be considered as explosions. Okay, that is, and much of the gas, large amount of gas also liberated in the explosion. Large amount of gas is liberated, it's huge amount of heat is produced, and light, huge amount of light is produced. It is going to give a huge amount of sound also. Such type of reactions can be considered as explosions. Okay. Now, let us discuss some think and discuss segment. Also, very important think and discuss segment is been given in page number 112. It is think and discuss segment. Why is phosphorus preserved in water? Why the phosphorus is preserved in water? See, phosphorus is a substance where the ignition temperature of the phosphorus is room temperature. That means at the room temperature it catches fire. Okay, no need of giving much. That is, at 32 degrees Celsius or 33 degrees Celsius, the phosphorus have a tendency of catching the fire. If it is kept just like that on the bench or anywhere, or any on the table or any sofa set or any place wherever it is, slowly due to the room temperature or at the nearby room temperature, slowly the phosphorus gets ignited and it catches fire. So it is, as the ignition temperature of the phosphorus is nearby the room temperature, so at the room temperature, as it is going to catch fire, it is preserved or it is stored in water. That is to maintain, to see that the phosphorus is not going to reach its ignition temperature. Okay, fine. Phosphorus will be ignited at the room temperature to prevent the damage caused due to the ignition of that phosphorus due to the room temperature. It is stored in the water to reduce its temperature, to low down its temperature, not to reach, to make sure that it is not going to reach the ignition temperature. Okay, why kerosene stove and burners have a small holes in them? See the combustion, in order to execute the process of combustion, supply of air should be there. That is, oxygen also should support. If the air flow is not there, there is no process of executing that combustion. Combustion process does not be executed. So to get the air flow, small holes will be there in the kerosene stove. It is hard to ignite a match stick in a rainy season, rainy day. Why? On a rainy day, why it is not, it's very difficult to ignite the match stick? Because if the rainy day, the climate is very cool and it is moisture, the atmosphere is very moisture. Okay, when we are striking, due to the more humidity or more amount of water vapor present around us, the mastic cannot get ignited. That mastic, while striking, it can't reach its respective ignition temperature, and it is very difficult to light that mastic in the rainy season or in a rainy day. Okay, this is what about a small think and discuss segment and types of combustions and explosions, and what is the process is being taken place while in order to light a matchstick. That's what is a small session of our this part 4 of the combustion fuels and flames. Okay, I hope you understood this session. Easy session. Next we are going to discuss about fuels. What are the types of fuels, how we use, and all. Very good explanation in the next class, in the next session. I hope you understood this session and all the topics. Okay. Thank you. And be far from these highly inflammable substances. Guide and educate the nearby your small your siblings or your friends. Educate them. The highly inflammable substances. You have to be very much far from this highly inflammable substance. It should not be surrounded by the fire. The fire should, we should not take the fire nearby these highly inflammable substances where there is a huge explosion can take place, okay, which is dangerous to our environment, nearby ourselves, environment and ourselves also. So don't play with the highly inflammable substances. That is a caution of this session. I hope you understood this. Thank you very much.